Today I am going to start a side to side VPN series. So welcome to my channel. We are going to start side to side VPN configuration in GNS3. So most of the video you'll see on the YouTube that is configured in Packet Tracer, but I thought to create it in GNS3. That is something like, you know, you feel some real time environment of this configuration. So let me start first the GNS, create a new project with side to side VPN. So giving its name as side to site VPN. Okay, so I have opened the new page for the new project side to side VPN. So before going toward this configuration, you just need to understand what is actually side to side VPN is and why you use in our network. As we know, all of our local area network works on layer 2, or you can say the data link layer. But if you want to communicate or different sites or different location or different branches together, or one branch with the another branch, we need to communicate via the layer 3, hence public networks. So if you are communicating on public network, that is a not trusted network, so we have to do something that can secure our data. So we have this best option to create a side-to-side VPN with the help of IP security. With the help of IP security, we can create a pre-shared keys on both of the sites. That pre-shared key will be exchangeable on both sides so that only the real or authenticated user can access the data. So first of all, we'll create a topology. So creating topology, I'm taking the router 1, this router for site 1 and router 2 for site 2. And these two sites will run over the ISP. So we required one more router for ISP also. So let me connect here the ISP. This one is the ISP router. So first of all, we'll connect F0/0 from R1 to R3 and F1/0 to F1/0 from R3 to R1. Okay, so this one is the ISP that provide the internet connectivity for the both of the sites, site 1 and site 2. So let me define here its name like site 1. This is site 1 and this is site 2. So this is site 1 and site 2, and this one is the ISP. So let me change its symbol for the internet connectivity. So go ahead and change this symbol for, you know, internet connectivity. I am taking this symbol as इंटरनेट लाइक दिस वाईफाई. सो दिस वन इज द आईएसपी. तो हमारा एड्रेस नेम आज आईएसपी. Then we need to connect the both side. I am going to connect two PCs on this side. So let me connect here one PC for this side and one PC for this side. And now we'll assign the IP addresses for both of the sides. So from R1 to R3 means site 1 to ISP and site 2 to ISP from R2 to R3, and define their IP addresses. So this is F0/0 and this one F1/0 that is connected through this, and this is F0/0. Okay, so let me define the addresses here. On this site, I'm giving address is 100.100.100.1, and this site, on this interface, you can say I'm giving here 2. On this interface I'm providing IP address as 192.168.1.1, and this site I am giving address as 172.16.1.1, Now we need to provide this side of the address. So this side I am giving address as let me configure like 50.50.50.1, or let me show it's 2, and this side I am giving address as 1. And these all addresses are 24 bits. This is also 24 bit, and this one also 24 bits. This is also 24 bits / 24, and this one also 24 bits. So let me configure the interfaces quickly, then we'll do the routing, and after that will configure the side to side VPNs parameters. So first of all, what we'll be do, we'll configure all of the interfaces, but let me start all of the devices first and maximize some sizes so that it can visible clearly. So now I have mentioned the addresses of all these interfaces. Like on R1 we have two interface, F0/0 and F1/0. R2 we have the F1/0 and F0/0, and their addresses we have defined 50.50.1 on F1/0, and on ISP side 50.50.2. So first of all, we'll start from the site 1 configurations. So let me start all of the device together here. and start the configuration from R1 and do some sort window so that you can see all the configuration well. Okay, yes, so now start from the R1. Okay, so let me configure. So first of all, I just need to change its host name so that it will be identical. So this we are given the host name as a site 1, so I'll write here site 1, and then we'll configure the interfaces. So the interface f1/0, its IP address, and then no shutdown. We have another interface f0/0, and its IP address 100.100.100.1 and 255.255.255.0, no shut, and we'll save it. And after that we'll configure the router 2, means you can say site 2. It have also the two interfaces. First of all, we'll change the host name site 2, then interface f1/0, that having address 50.50.50.1 and no shut. Next interface we having the f0/0, its IP address 172.16.1.1 with 24 bit of the subnet mask, and no shut. Then we need to configure the ISP router, that is the R3. So it having two interfaces also, f0/0, and its address is 100.100.100.2, 255.255.0, and no shut. Next interface, we have another interface is f1/0, that having 50.50.255.255.0, no shut. Okay, so we have done the interface configuration. Now we need to do the routing also. So from site 1 to ISP we'll do the default routing, site 2 to ISP we'll do the default routing, and from ISP to site 1 we'll do the static routing, from ISP to site 2 also do the static routing. So let's start from the site 1. Okay, so we'll open the site 1 router, means R1, and go inside the configuration mode, and we'll write the command IP route 0.0.0 for network, and for subnet also define 0.0.0 and via 100.100.100.2. That is the next neighbor address we'll define here, and enter, then save it, and go on the other side, site 2, and do the same default routing, IP route 0.0.0.0 and 0.0.0 via next neighbor address 50.50.50.2. Save it, and then we'll go on the router 3, means ISP router. So this side, from ISP to site 1, will do the static routing. So for this ISP to site 1, we having the IP route 192.168.1.0 and 255.255.255.0, and the via address will be 100.100.100.1, means next neighbor address we have in this. Now we'll save it, and another we have the site is 172.16, that is on the site 2, 172.16.1.0, 255.255.255.0, 255.0, and 50.50.50.1 is the next neighbor address. Now we'll save this configuration, and next what will you do, we'll provide the IP address on both side of the end devices, like PC1 and PC2. PC1 on site 1, so we'll provide IP address IP 192.168.1.2/24, and gateway will be 192.168.1.1, and on PC2 will provide the IP address 172.16.1.2/255.255.255.0, gateway. Now we need to check all the connectivity, means our whole complete network should be in the running condition, then we'll configure the side to side VPN. So let me check to ping the other side PC, ping 172.116.1.1. this one is the gateway, and we need to ping this PC itself, that is having the two address. So this is also communicating, means our complete network is working. Then now we need to understand, we have two sites, site 1 and site 2, and these two sites have, site 1 have the pairing address of peer address 100.100.100.1, and site 2 have the pairing address of 50.50.50.1. so these two peers are responsible for any incoming or outgoing traffics. So now we can start the configuration of site-to-site VPN. From the site 1, means router 1, will open the configuration mode and go inside the configuration mode. Type crypto EzaKMP enable. This is the first command that will need to run, crypto EzaKMP enable, then crypto EzaKMP policy, and we need to assign the policy number. So we can give the any number, just if you put a question mark, you have the option from 1 to 1000 priority of the protection suite. So I just given here 50, and authentication is pre-shared. The authentication will be pre-shared, that will be shared on both sides. Next, encryption is 3DS, and enter, then hash MD5, message digest 5, then we'll create a group, that you can give the any group number. So we'll start it from the one Diffie-Hellman group that have this 768 bits. So then lifetime, we'll run the command lifetime 3600, and after that we'll exit. Next we'll run the command crypto EzaKMP key, that we can define as, suppose I want to define this key as, let me show it, CCNA123, and its address, means address means the pairing address. So the pairing address will be the next site address, that will be 50.50.50.1. so we'll define it 50.50.50.1. next we'll run the command crypto IPsec transform set. Then you need to provide its name. You can provide any word, any name for your transform set. I'm giving here my set. The name is my set. Then encryption type ESP-3DS then ESP MD5, MHSE, and then go on the next part that will configure the access list. So for that we need to create an access list in configuration mode. From we'll exit here and go inside the configuration mode and create access list. Access list, then access list number. So I am giving here number as a 120, then permit IP. So what IP we are going to permit is means our local IP, that on site one. So we have to provide or permit the whole network like 192.168.1.0. this is our local site network that we need to assign or permit. So we'll write here 192.168.1.0 and its wildcard mask will be 0.0.0.255. next, for which network I am going to provide it, means permitting is, so the next side network is 172.16.1.0. so we'll write here 192.172.1.0 and its wildcard mask 0.0.0.255, and then we'll create a crypto map IP securities. So on configuration mode we'll write the command crypto map, then the name of the map. So I'm just giving its name like my map, and then policy number that we have defined, that is we have defined 50. So we'll write here 50, and then IP security as a KMP, we'll define this. Next, set the peering address, set peer. So the peering address will be the next site address, that is we having the 50.50.50.1. so we'll define here 50.50.50.1. next we'll set the transform set, set transform set, and its name is we have defined as a my set, so we'll clear his my set. Next one is match address, means access list address. So that we have given 120, so define here 120, and then exit from this interface. And now we have to apply all these policies and security encryption on the outgoing interface of your site. So this one is the outgoing interface of site 1, F0/0. So under this interface F0/0, we'll write the command crypto map, and the name of the map we have defined is my map. So we'll define it my map. Now we can say the crypto map is a KMP is on. We'll come out from this configuration mode and save it, and again go on the other side. So on other side also we'll configure the same. We need to configure all this configuration similarly. So go on the other side and enable its site 2. So let me configure this one on site 2. On site 2 we'll run the same configuration, a little bit change only you need to do. So crypto is a KMP enable, run the same command, then crypto is a KMP policy, crypto is a KMP policy, and then we need to define the policy number that we have already defined 50. So we'll run here 50, then authentication that is the pre-shared, then encryption, that is 3DES, and hashing algorithm MD5. Group that we have already defined is 1, and lifetime values we have defined as 3600. Next one, exit from here, and as well as this address. So crypto is a KMP key. Crypto is a KMP key, and on site one we have defined CCNA, not Cisco. We have defined CCNA 123, and address is the other side address will define 100.100.100.1. That is the first site outgoing interface address. That is the peering address, you can say. Next, we'll set the transform set. So we'll write the command crypto ipsec transform set, and its name we have given as the my set. Then ESP3DS encryption type, and ESP MD5 HMSE. Next, what we need to do, next we'll enter and create a access list. So let me start with the access list. So we'll create the access list. So access list, then its number we have defined earlier is 120, so we'll define here 120. Then permit IP, and which IP you want to permit, that is this side is 172.16.1.0, and its wildcard mask 0.0.0.0.0.255, and another side network is 192, means site 1 address 192.168.1.0, and its wildcard mask. So 172 network is allowed for access of 192.168. Next, we'll create a crypto map. So crypto map, then the name of the map that we have already defined, my map, so we define here also my map. Then policy number 50 we have given, so this number will be 50. IP security is a KMP, and then set peer address will be the site 1 address, that is 100.100.100.1. enter. Then set transform set, that is we have given name as my set, and then match address, and the address is 120, that access list number we have given there. Now we'll exit from here and go on the outgoing interface of site 2. So that is F1/0. So we'll go inside the F1/0, and then run the command crypto map my map. So this side also we have configured this, and ISA KMP is on, you can see. Now we'll come out from configuration mode and test it. To save this, we'll write command, and again we'll ping PC1 to PC2. So it will now successful, or site to site VPN configuration is successful and it is working fine. If you want to verify, we can run the some verification command to check the site to site VPN. So ISA KMP SA, that is the security association. So you can see that it is showing the destination as 50.50.50.1. Source is 100.100.100.1, and its connection ID is active. So next command will run crypto ipsec sa. सो क्रिप्टो आईपी सिक्योरिटी, सो क्रिप्टो आईपी सेक एसए। इन दिस यू कैन सी दैट क्रिप्टो मैप टैग इज लोकल एड्रेस 100.100.1 एंड लोकल 192.168.1.0 इज द नेटवर्क ऑफ आवर साइट 1.172.16.1.0 इज द साइट 2 एड्रेस। करेंट पियरिंग एड्रेस इज 50.50.50.1 एंड पोर्ट इज 500। इनकैप्सुलेटेड पैकेट्स दैट इज गोइंग टू डाइजेस्ट विद 4 एंड रिसीविंग अदर साइड ऑल्सो इट इज रिसीविंग ऑन द 4 इनक्रिप्टेड साइट्स। लोकल क्रिप्टो एंड पॉइंट्स दैट इज 100.100.1 एंड रिमोट क्रिप्टो एंड पॉइंट इट इज शोइंग एज 50.50.1। सो यू कैन सी द इन बाउंड इनकैप्सुलेशन एज पर द इन बाउंड एच एस एस ए पी एस पी आउट बाउंड्स। सो ऑल द कन्फिग्रेशन एंड सिक्योरिटी एसोसिएशन वी कैन चेक इट हियर। Another command we can check it out the verification in the so crypto engine connections active. So it is showing the active connections that we having on the site 1, and same thing we can check on the site 2 also. So this is all about the site to site VPN that we have configured and verify, and it is working properly. If you communicate from one side to another side, even your one network to another network, means PC1 and PC2 both are communicating with each other via the help of site to site VPNs. We can configure site to multi site also. We have just given an example of site to site VPN. If you want to configure site to multi site VPN, that you can do also. So watch my video, share it, subscribe it and like it, and if you having any queries you can comment me and definitely I'll reply this. Thanks for watching my video.